Brothers and sisters in Christ, originally, the Poong Nazareno was scheduled to arrive in Bohol on the 22nd or 23rd of November. There were changes of plans and he arrived 2 days ahead of time. Perhaps he wanted to join the culmination of the 2021 World Youth Day celebration in the Diocese of Tagbilaran. Pinangga gyud sa Poong Nazareno ang mga kabatanunan sa dioceses sa Tagbilaran. Ato siyang daigon og pasalamatan pinaagi sa usa ka masigabong palakpakan. Perhaps the Poong Nazareno also wanted to be with us as we celebrate the solemnity of Christ the King. Pinangga man ta niyang tanan. Gusto niya nga masabtan ug mabati nato unsa siya nga matang sa hari. In the Gospel, Pilate asked Jesus, "Are you the King of the Jews?" And the Lord replies, "My kingdom does not belong to this world." In a way, Jesus clarifies to Pilate and to us all today that his kingdom is unlike worldly kingdoms. Siya usa ka hari nga andam magsakripisyo para kanato. Dili siya hari nga magpaserbisyo. O hari nga magpahayahay lang sama sa emperador. Siya hari nga mupasan ug muatubang sa tanang kalisdanan alang sa atong kaluwasan. Ang Poong Nazareno gusto nga mahimong hari sa tagsa-tagsa nato kakinabuhi. Ang pangutana karon, ato ba siyang dawaton? Siya ba ang atong pahariyon diya sa atong tagsa-tagsa kakasing-kasing? Do we allow Jesus to be our one and only King? Pakpakan nato ang Ginoo. The coming of Poong Nazareno to the Diocese of Tagbilaran is providential. Before COVID-19, we were already facing a very serious issue affecting many of our people, especially the young. The problem of depression and suicide. This problem is not unique in our diocese. In fact, it's a universal phenomenon. Daghan sa mga kabatanunan karon sa tibuok kalibutan, dali ra maluya ug dali ra mawad-ag paglaom. Walay usa ka hinungdan niini. It's a combination of many factors that include poverty, social media pressures, and the gradual loss of faith in many people today. As bishop and father of the diocese, I was deeply troubled. I prayed and reflected seriously. What can I possibly do to address the problem? And then there was the inspiration. The Black Nazarene came to my mind. Magtanaw ko sa Poong Nazareno ug makita nako ang Dios nga atubangon ang tanang kalisod tungod ug alang sa gugma. I believe that God gave us the Poong Nazareno for a special reason. He saved us by carrying the cross and allowed himself to be crucified so that we will understand the immensity of His love. But by giving us the Poong Nazareno, God also teaches us that there is salvific value in carrying crosses, and that we need to carry our own cross in imitation to His Son. One spiritual writer said this: Christ did not suffer so that we wouldn't suffer. He suffered so that when we suffer, we will become like Him. Mga igsoon, si Kristo nagpas-an og krus aron kita pod makat-on sa pagpas-an sa atong krus ug mahisama niya. So we should not be afraid to face challenges and trials. We can carry our cross no matter how big, because we are not carrying it alone. Jesus carries the cross with us. And so I started longing to have a Poong Nazareno shrine in the Diocese of Tagbilaran. Para dunagyud tay palay para niya dinhi sa ato. In my mind and heart, I thought of having a shrine that will also become a center in the diocese where we can gather our young people regularly to be instructed and formed to become like the Black Nazarene, loving, humble, merciful, sacrificial, yet strong and courageous, always willing to face trials and difficulties. In other words, I dream of inspiring the heart of every young Boholano as spirituality of the Black Nazarene. Kanang kasing-kasing ba nga puno sa gugma, dili mo atras sa mga problema ug dili mawad ag paglaom bisan kun kini lisod-lisoron. There were signs of God's loving support and approval. Last Christmas, I received a gift package from a friend in Manila. It came as a little surprise because this was the first time I ever received a Christmas gift from him. Lo and behold, when I opened the small package, inside was a small, simple picture frame with an image of the Black Nazarene. This friend never heard of our thoughts and plans for the Black Nazarene, but he was used by God to inspire us more. A few years back, the diocese already sent a request to Quiapo Church to give us a pilgrim image of the Black Nazarene. But for one reason or another, we have received no response from them. Then I was inspired to seek the help of our dear friend, Corito Bautista. Sabi ko, Corito, baka pwede mo kaming tulungan na magkaroon ng Black Nazarene dito sa Tagbilaran. And she willingly agreed to approach Monsignor Ding Coronel and told him about our request. After her meeting with the good parish priest of Quiapo, Corito immediately informed me of the good news. Monsignor Coronel has tasked the committee in charge to make one pilgrim image of the Black Nazarene for the Diocese of Tagbilaran. Indeed, my dear friends, it is true. God make things beautiful in His time. Pakpaka na to ang Ginoo. As we celebrate today the feast of Christ the King, it would be nice for us to consider seriously the Lord's commission to all His disciples. If we proclaim Jesus as King, we must heed His call. Let us live our lives in imitation to Jesus' life and ministry in the world today. The world today does not need a great leader to save it from poverty and misery. It only needs every Christian to exercise the kingship that he or she shares with Christ in baptism. To the faithful of Tagbilaran, especially to our young people, let us all start a special devotion to Poong Nazareno. I highly encourage you to start praying to the Black Nazarene in churches, chapels, and in our homes. It would also be good if we can have our own little image of the Black Nazarene in our families and start catechizing our children about the great sacrifice that God did for us in Jesus. In this way, our children will start to understand the value of true love and genuine sacrifice for the good of others. To Monsignor Ding Coronel and the parish of St. John the Baptist in Quiapo, to Father Daniel Voltaire Hui and Father L. Alison Valdez, to Ma'am Corito Bautista, to Ma'am Ali Castillo, to the hijos who are here, thank you so much for all your love and support to the Diocese of Tagbilaran. May you always find your way to the heart of the Black Nazarene.